This is Coding Math Mini number 7, Radians in Degrees. Now, I've touched on this subject a little bit during the early videos in trigonometry, but I thought it deserved a little bit more in-depth discussion. For most of the work you'll do with angles in many languages, you'll need to use radians rather than degrees. Some languages use a hybrid, such as Flash's ActionScript, which uses radians for most mathematical operations, but the rotation property of a movie clip uses degrees. In CSS, you specify the units directly, such as 90 DEG or 2 RAD. Anyway, radians are common enough that you should understand them thoroughly. The term radian comes from radius. Now, you should know what a radius is. If we have a circle here, the radius is the distance from the center of the circle to the edge. Of course, a circle is the set of points that are all the same distance from a center point. So no matter what angle you measure the radius from, it will be the same. Now say you stretched a piece of string along the radius here, snipped it off to be exactly that length, and then wrapped it along the edge of the circle here. That string would now form an arc. The angle of that arc would be 1 radian. In degrees, that would be about 57.295 degrees. To get a little insight on that, let's look at an equilateral triangle. All three sides are the same. So, all three angles are the same. We know that the angles of a triangle will always add up to 180 degrees. So these angles must equal 60 degrees each. Now, if we go back to our 1 radian arc, and we connect this last side to form a triangle, we see that we have two sides equal, as they are both 1 radius long, but this last side is slightly less than 1 radius. So this angle will be slightly less than 60 degrees. Right around 57.295 to be a bit more accurate. Next, let's continue wrapping this string around the circle. Two lengths and we have an angle of 2 radians, or about 114.59 degrees. Three times gives us 171.89. Just a little bit more gives us 180 degrees. It's actually right around 3.14, or pi, radians. And if we wrap it all the way around to 360 degrees, it's 6.28, or 2 pi radians. Now this makes sense when you consider the definition of pi itself. It's the ratio of a diameter of a circle to its circumference. So pi equals circumference divided by diameter. Doing some algebra, we can transform that into circumference equals diameter times pi. Now the diameter is basically 2 times the radius, so we can say circumference equals 2 times radius times pi, or 2 pi times radius. And since the circumference represents 360 degrees around the circle, and a radius defines 1 radian, we can say that 360 degrees equals 2 pi radians. Now we can create some conversion formulas. Since we know that 180 degrees equals pi radians, we can divide any degree value by 180 and multiply by pi to get radians. So radians equals degrees divided by 180 times pi. And some simple algebra transforms that into the opposite formula, degrees equals radians times 180 divided by pi. I'll add those to our utils library as functions called degrees to rads and rads to degrees. Now I've set up a simple demo file that will draw a shape rotated to a specified angle. This just translates the drawing context to the center of the canvas, rotates the context, and then draws a circle and a line. So if we want to rotate 37 degrees, for example, we can convert that to radians by saying angle equals utils dot degrees to rads 37. And you see that it draws the shape rotated to 37 degrees. Try this with some other angles to see that it works. Now for some common angles, you should know the radian values without needing to resort to a conversion formula. For example, 0 radians is obviously 0 degrees. 2 pi radians is 360 degrees, and pi radians is 180 degrees. You should just know these without thinking about them. From there, it's easy to derive that 90 degrees is simply pi divided by 2 radians, and 45 degrees is pi divided by 4 radians. So we can say angle equals math pi divided by 4, and that will draw the shape rotated to 90 degrees. Now remember that for canvas, angles will go around clockwise. So if you wanted 90 degrees counterclockwise, you could either use minus math pi divided by 2 to rotate it in the opposite direction, or you could just rotate it 270 degrees, which would simply be math pi divided by 1.5, or math pi times 3 divided by 2. So that's all for today. Nothing crazy, but hopefully that gives you a little bit better understanding of degrees and radians.